You're standing outside, maybe heading to work, maybe watching the clouds roll by. And then it happens. The Earth stops spinning, not slows down, not gradually, just stops. You don't feel it at first, but then the air hits. The ground stays still, but everything else, everything, keeps moving at over 1,000 miles per hour. The atmosphere doesn't stop with the planet. Winds howl louder than any storm you've ever heard. Trees are torn from the ground. Skyscrapers buckle and fall sideways. Cars, people, animals, flung eastward like leaves in a tornado. Near the equator, it's the worst. That's where the spin was fastest. The destruction is total. Oceans rise into the air. Entire coastlines vanish under walls of water hundreds of feet tall. The tsunamis don't come from earthquakes. They come from momentum. All that water still trying to move as Earth refuses to. Planes fall from the sky. Power lines snap. The grid fails. Everything we've built, designed for a world that spins, is no longer built for this. And the chaos doesn't stop after the winds die down. With no rotation, weather patterns unravel. The jet streams break apart. Storm systems collapse or go rogue. Fires ignite from exploding fuel lines. Smoke chokes the sky. And all the while, the sun hangs frozen in the sky, unmoving, just staring down. You try to run. But where do you go when the laws of motion just turned against you? This isn't just disaster, it's planetary whiplash. In just a few minutes, the world as you knew it is unrecognizable. Not because it broke, but because it stopped. And yet the worst hasn't even arrived. Because once the dust settles, that's when the planet starts to shift in other ways. Ways you're not ready for. Ways no one could be ready for. You survived the winds, the waves, the fires. Somehow you're still standing. But now the world around you starts to feel wrong. The ground beneath your feet is heavier. You're not imagining it. Your body is literally being pulled down harder than before. Gravity hasn't changed, but something else has. You see, Earth isn't perfectly round. Because it spins, it bulges slightly at the equator, pushing land and water outward. But now that the spin is gone, that bulge, it starts to collapse. And when the shape of the planet changes, so does everything else. Water begins to migrate, not instantly, but slowly, powerfully. Oceans that once hugged the equator begin to drain toward the poles. Sea levels rise in places like Canada, Northern Europe, and Siberia, swallowing entire regions that were once dry land. Cities vanish under the rising tide. Meanwhile, tropical coasts that once teemed with life start to dry up. The equator becomes a dust belt. What used to be rich rainforest might turn to desert. The Amazon, gone. The Congo, cracked and dry. You look out at a land that once pulsed with life, and now it's barren. And it's not just the oceans that are on the move. The Earth's crust begins to shift too. Relieved of the constant centrifugal force, tectonic plates begin to settle into new positions. Pressure builds where there was balance. Earthquakes ripple across continents. Volcanoes stir. Mountains rise or crumble. Your weight keeps changing depending on where you stand. Near the poles, you feel lighter, almost floaty. Near the equator, heavier, like you're dragging an invisible chain behind you. Your muscles ache. Your balance feels off. Even your blood flow adjusts as your body tries to relearn a new version of down. You're on the same planet, but it's not the same Earth. It looks different. It feels different. The air is still. The oceans are confused. The land is reshaping itself beneath your feet. And the question that begins to haunt you isn't what just happened. It's what's next. Because without Earth's spin, something even more fundamental is about to break. Time. You wake up, if you even manage to sleep, and the sun is still in the exact same spot in the sky. It hasn't moved, not even a little. There's no sunrise, no sunset, just one long, eternal moment, frozen in time. If you're on the side of Earth facing the sun, daylight never ends, and not the soft kind. This is scorching, merciless light. Without the cooling effect of rotation, the heat builds, hour after hour, day after day. The ground cracks open, lakes evaporate, crops wither, Animals collapse under the brutal sun. The sky turns white with haze and dust, and the temperature keeps rising. But on the other side of the planet, it's worse. Darkness reigns, permanent night. The air grows cold and still. Snow falls, then never melts. Cities freeze solid. Power grids fail, and with no sunlight, solar energy is useless. Even fire starts to feel like a precious resource. And somewhere in between the two sides, between boiling and frozen, there's a narrow strip of twilight. It's dim, cold but not deadly, warm but not boiling, and it becomes the only place left where life might stand a chance. You might live there, if you're lucky, if you're fast. But even in this twilight zone, things are changing. Without rotation, wind patterns collapse. Ocean currents stall. Rain doesn't fall where it used to. Clouds don't form. Storms don't move. The planet's weather engine has stopped. You try to grow food, but the seasons are gone. You try to mark time, but the sky doesn't move. You lose your sense of morning and night and meaning. And all across the world, you start to realize something terrifying. The Earth didn't just stop spinning, it stopped breathing. And soon, it may stop protecting you altogether. Because far beneath your feet, something ancient is shutting down. And without it, the sun is about to become your greatest enemy. Deep beneath your feet, Earth's core used to spin. Liquid iron flowing around a solid center, generating something invisible, but vital. The magnetic field. It wrapped around the planet like a shield, blocking deadly solar wind, deflecting radiation, protecting everything you've ever known. But without rotation, that dynamo begins to fail. At first, you don't notice. There's no sound, no shaking, but satellites start going dark. GPS scrambles, radios flicker with static. The invisible barrier above you is weakening. Then, high above Earth, the sun unleashes a flare. It hurls charged particles toward the planet. Normally, the magnetic field bends them away. Now, they pierce through the atmosphere. You see strange lights in the sky, auroras in places that never had them. They're beautiful, mesmerizing, and deadly. Radiation levels spike. Airlines stop flying. Cancer cases rise. The power grid flickers, then fails. And this is only the beginning, because if the magnetic field vanishes entirely, Earth's atmosphere becomes vulnerable. Over time, it could be stripped away by the solar wind, just like what happened to Mars. Imagine that, Earth, once lush and alive, slowly turning into a frozen, airless wasteland. You try to shield yourself, lead walls, underground bunkers, radiation suits, but the danger is constant, and it's everywhere. It's in the air, the water, the light. Electronics fail permanently. Communication is lost. There's no internet, no weather warnings, no rescue. And it's not just humans that suffer. Birds can't navigate. Whales beach themselves. Species that rely on magnetic fields to migrate are suddenly blind. The world feels unrecognizable. Not because of what you can see, but because of what you can't. The protection you always had, the force that quietly watched over you, has vanished. And the sun, once a source of life, now feels like a threat. You wonder how much longer the planet can take it, how much longer you can take it. Because if this is the new Earth, then survival is no longer about strength. It's about shelter. It's about adaptation. And it's about finding the last place where life can still hold on. If you're still alive, it's not by chance. It's because you adapted. Maybe you found a home in the twilight zone, that thin, flickering band between endless light and eternal night. A place where it's neither too hot nor too cold. But even here, life is fragile. You live underground now. The surface is too exposed, too dangerous. Radiation from the sun seeps into everything. Skin burns faster, eyes stay sensitive. The sky isn't blue anymore. It's pale, washed out, tired. The days don't pass, not like they used to. You track time with clocks, not shadows. You try to remember what it felt like to watch the sun rise and set, to feel days flow in and out like breathing. Now it's just survival. Artificial lights, hydroponic farms, clean air made by machines, communities built like bunkers, sealed, silent. Some say we could make it work, build rotating cities, simulate night and day, shield ourselves from space. Maybe we could, but what kind of world would that be? No birds in the morning, no tides on the shore, no stars that drift across the sky. Just a planet frozen in time. And you'd start to wonder, did we really lose the spin? Or did we lose something deeper? Because the Earth's rotation wasn't just physics, it was rhythm. It was life. It marked every story we've ever told, every hour we've ever lived. It gave us the rising of the sun, the passing of time, the sense that tomorrow would come, and now without it, you realize something you never thought about before. The Earth turning wasn't just motion, it was a promise, a quiet, constant whisper that no matter what happens, the world goes on. But now that whisper is gone, and all you can do is listen to the silence.